Hello, everyone. My name is the Radman, and we are here for another Courseplay tutorial. So, in the last one, I showed you how to set up a basic grain transfer route, a combining route, the combine's way over there, and I also showed you how to simply automatically unload a combine using this. And today I'm going to be showing you how to rake, bale, and then collect the straw automatically. I wouldn't recommend setting up a course with just a baler, just because it's kind of interesting the way you have to do it. But anyway, actually, another one you could do, I guess, if you wanted, is you could make the baler copy the combine's route, but that usually is better with big balers, and just know that it will miss stuff on the end because of the way that the balers turn. But anyway, so the first step is we are going to need to figure out how big this is. It is 8.6 meters. And just for reference, we're going to now go... I should have just tabbed. We're going to go to our trailer, and they all need to be in field work mode, by the way. And we're going to see if we can set this to 8.6. Because the key to this setup is that the rake and 8.6, good. And when you get larger rakes and stuff, if a rake is 0.3, these usually only go up in increments of 0.5 when you get above a certain value. I think it's like 10 or 11. And you'll have to just ramp it all the way down to zero and then put it back up, and it will stay at a rounded number. And that'll make more sense when you start having to mess with the larger rake. But anyway, let me show you what you have to do now that that's in place. So now that they both have the same thing, we're going to make sure that we're talking about the same field, which is field 16. We're going to be starting from the northeast corner, and we are going to be going west. There we go, see? And I have it so that I can see all the waypoints just to make sure everything matches up. And now we are pretty well done with the raking part, but what we're going to do is save it as field 16 rake. And now if we play this, it's going to fold it up because it needs to pull forward a little bit, but then it should get going. Yep, see, it was just a little bit off on its alignment. And now what we're going to do is we're going to get the baler set up. So that's going to go. We have field 16 rake. This was from a scrapped recording, so I'll just delete it. But anyway, so now the reason that we loaded the rake course is we want this baler to follow exactly in the footsteps of the rake. The only problem is that if it's a baler like this, you have to account for the offset. So to do that, you go into the settings, field work mode is very important. Anyway, you go into tractor on field work mode, and you can do the tool offset. Now, that is basically calculating, like, where the interactive part of the tool is compared to where you're driving. So let's say I need to be this far off for the baler to pick up all the straw. So we need to move away from this waypoint. We need to move to the left. So if we start scrolling like this, I'm just using my mouse wheel. You can also do it like this. And what we're going to do is move this about that much over, and then we'll hit drive course and go back in. And now what's going to happen is that is pretty well exactly spot on, and this is going to drive dead center in the middle of the windrows, and it's just going to plop out the bales as it goes. Now, it's important to note that if you have to offset a bigger baler, you'll also have to offset the bale pickup. this is especially important if you're using the in-game Arcusin auto stacker, or Arcusin, I don't know how you're supposed to say it, but like if it has where this folds down to the side, if for some reason you had a modded baler that you had to put the offset to the side, you'd have to go the original offset and then offset it more, because like I believe the default amount that you have to offset the Arcusin auto stack for it to work properly is 2.5 meters to the left, because most balers, or at least the bigger balers, shouldn't have this thing where the bales fly as they fall out. So most of the bales should stay in alignment well enough that it'll be able to pick them up. Now, one thing you may notice, besides the fact that I forgot to fix this, is that it will miss a little bit at the top and bottom, and what I usually do is I usually just drive the rake over the top and bottom after the bale collector has gone over, and then, I just do that. But anyway, now we'll go on to bale collection, which is simultaneously the easiest and hardest thing to do, because there are a few things to keep in mind. One thing is that this trailer, if I put it in work mode, you can see it is now picking up bales automatically, which means it is working as expected, and if this doesn't work, there are small bale pickups available. I would recommend, if you're going to go with small bales, though, I would recommend, even though I don't necessarily like the Money Cheat mod, I do use it for stuff like these tutorials, so I would recommend downloading some version of a Money Cheat mod, because if you don't, you'll end up buying equipment that either doesn't work or conflicts with each other. But anyway, so it's important to remember this has to be the exact same as this rake, and we'll find out why. So first we're going to go northeast, and we went west, yes. So notice the field looks exactly the same, but this is not the correct field because we have to return to the first point. Now if I show this, we should see, oops. Now what's going to happen is when this trailer gets full, it's going to come to the end of this row if there's a part two of the course. So we're going to save this as field 16. Did I save that other one as field 17? Anyway, we'll have this be bale collect. Oops, if I can spell. So basically this course exists to pick up bales, and we're probably going to want to offset it just because even though this trailer can pick up in front of the tractor, it doesn't always do it very accurately. But anyway, now it's important that you remember this step when you're making courses. So now what you're going to do is for first, you're going to need to understand how your trailer is going to unload. So for instance, I'm going to choose that it will unload. Does it really only have two? Let's see what that does. Okay, X to pick them back up, then X to turn it off, then B. Okay, so it's just not saying the other options. Okay, so B, B, B. Okay, so we want it to be offloading in the back if we can. And worst case scenario, what you can do is, if this doesn't work to do it automatically, you can make it so that the tractor will tell you, you can go and stop the course, and if you have it set to nearest waypoint, it'll just resume. So, for instance, I'll show you the way of doing it non-automatically, because I just realized I'm not sure how well this is going to work, and we have encountered one of our first problems. That tool doesn't want to work, so if we just put it into a transfer, that doesn't even want to work. So apparently this trailer is not actually very well supported, so this would hold up if this trailer was working as intended. For the sake of this, though, I'll see if I can find another one that I know will work. The only problem is I've been recently thinning down the amount of mods I have, so some of them that I know Courseplay would like, I don't have anymore. I think we're going to get this one just because it of these two, it is probably more likely to work with Courseplay. And if not, I'll explain it to you, and then I can show it with a big baler or something later. So we'll just drop this off, because this course will still work with this other trailer. And that's the nice thing about these courses, is most of them will continue to work even if you like upgrade your baler or something. Of course, if you upgrade your rake, you'll have to remake all the courses, but you'd have to do that anyway. So we'll turn the HUD on just so we can see. We'll just come pick up some random bales. Okay, good. It's working properly. Drive. I don't want it in a transfer route if I can. Yes, okay. So this trailer does work in fieldwork mode. And notice it is getting close enough to the bales that it is barely clipping them, but they are not causing major jamage. Now, if they were jamming up the wheels like it's doing there, you'll just increase the offset to 3.1. And now if it can turn around without killing itself, we should see that it will work. Okay, it was probably just recomputing what it had to do to get over enough. And see, now it's not hitting as many bales. So anyway, we'll see when this fills up. Just double checking that the rake isn't done yet. Good. Yeah. So the one thing that I do not like about this trailer over that other trailer is that you have to be very careful with this trailer because it unloads straw. And that's not a common problem that you're going to have, especially like, I would actually recommend if you're going to be course playing baling, skip the small bales and go to large bales. Because, like, I could see course playing the baling and raking of the fields, but course playing the loading of small bales is just asking for trouble, especially when many of the small balers, instead of reliably doing the bales in a certain way like a big baler does, they kind of just shoot them off like fireworks in every direction. And I would have shown a big baler. The only problem is it's hard to sometimes get a full load on such a small field, even with a crop that gives as much straw as wheat does. But anyway, we are 144 out of 245. I don't know why I had such a hard time saying that. And yeah, oh, one thing that you'll note is the rake and baler are moving at a constant enough pace that the rake is staying ahead, and that's important. You can have multiple courses running in the same field, and they shouldn't, you know, cause any trouble unless one of them goes to return to start and it hits another one. Like, that's why I recommend, unless you're doing something like baling, or I'll show you seeding and fertilizing, those three situations should be the only ones where you need to use the return to start feature, unless you just have like one field out in the middle of nowhere that's huge and you don't want to have to drive the combine back from the other side when it gets done, which I could see also happening if it was like, let's just say for instance you owned field 9 and you started it over by the flour mill, but you wanted to do field 8, you'd tell it to return to start at field 9, and that just means if you ever bought field 12, you might have to remake the course. But anyway, we are about full, so we'll get to see what happens. So since this is the only course set up, it's going to stop and say it needs to be unloaded, so I'll come unload it. And then we'll see if we can get an automatic thing set up for it. The only problem is that with these things. Oh wait, this. Oh, they might have updated it this year to actually do stacks, but last year it didn't do stacks. But what we're going to do is we're going to see if we can get this silly thing to back into this. That's the other thing I don't like is this hay selling point is absolute garbage. So yeah, if I was using Courseplay, wait until you have a wagon that you can back up, just because you'll never get one of these things in the back. But if you do manage to get them in the back, what you do is you just have them unload somewhere. The game's going to absolutely tank because 245 objects are colliding with each other. And as long as the game does not crash, we shall be okay. There we go. Now just never drive over by that pile again. So yeah, with this trailer, it's not really an option. But what you would do normally, I'll just unhook this so I can show you. What you would normally do is you would still be in fieldwork mode. You'd go to the end, like where your trailer is going to when it gets full. And then you basically just drive like this. And you drive to the point where you're going to unload it. And I'll show you how to, like, if you have, like, a really big trailer that you need to back up, I'll show you how to do that. So just because that's a lag pile, let's say that directly behind me, I'll close that, directly behind me back there is the sell point. So what I would do is I would back up like this, and let's say that the sell point where the bales would need to be unloaded is right here. Now what's important to remember is you have to have the tractor right here when you put the when you take it out of reverse and put the waiting point, because the waiting point is what the back when the back of the trailer hits the waiting point, that's what triggers the unload. So if you make the waiting point, for instance, up here, you're going to end up with a lot of problems, because instead of unloading back here where you want it, it's going to be unloading up there because that's where the waiting point is. And then what I recommend is, if you can, drive as far forward as possible, because if you turn too sharply out of like a shed or something, especially since the tractor has to be in there to begin with, you'll end up hitting stuff. And I can probably find, oh, I don't have footage of it, but I'll just show you. And then you just pull back in and stop the course, and you don't back up at the end because I skidded a little bit. But yeah, if I had an actual trailer that actually worked, that would be how you would make the unloading course. And then what you do is you load first the bale collect course, and then I just call it bale sell. And then what happens is when bale collect is finished, it runs bale sell. And then it, when it gets back to the front, it rescans the field to see where you were at as far as, like, emptying the field. And then it automatically sends the tractor back to where it was. But, yeah, I'm sorry I couldn't show you it. It's just that a field this small probably wouldn't have given enough to properly show it anyway. And, yeah. I think what I'll do, though, is I will make a tutorial on how to do it with big bales. But just for instance, I don't actually have the mod installed, but I know that Giants released a pack of historical farm equipment, and I know that the bale collector in that actually just pushes the bales out the back, and it's a, and you can like back it up and stuff. So if you could somehow get that to work with the fact that, oh, this is going to lag so bad. If you could get that to work with the fact that the bales pop out all over the place and it would still pick them up, then you would be able to actually back them up into this little shed. But one, what I would recommend doing personally, especially if you plan on selling a lot of bales, is just, oops, has to be in mods, is downloading the straw power plant mod and putting it somewhere not quite as laggy as right there. Somewhere, oh, forgot, you can't put it on the pavement. Somewhere like over here, preferably not where it has to be built up on a mound. But it should be somewhere that can be backed or driven. Yeah, it would have to be backed into if it's like the straw power plant mod. But if you had like a shed that sells bales that are put in it, you could just drive through it and put the waiting point in the middle of the shed. That would work too. Anyway, I just hope that the audio hasn't got like majorly distorted by that pile of bales. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. We'll just really quickly see. There we go. We'll get this full. Turn that off. Oh, it does not like that. 1, 2, 3. So we should have it unloading at the back now. And I'm pretty sure that's a glitch where it says unloading center every time. And as long as we get this right, it's going to lag really bad, but then it's going to realize that all the bales need sold. So let's watch the money. There we go. It didn't actually lag that bad because it sold them all instantaneously. There we go. Pick up these just to get them out of the way because I don't like the lag. But anyway, guys, I'll finish that off camera. And I guess with this type of trailer, you could actually make a course that would work. The only problem is CoursePlay doesn't support it. So, yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. My name is The Rad Man, and I'll see you in the next episode. Oh, but down in the comments, why don't you guys tell me whether you would prefer a tutorial of how to do, like, basically this setup with big balers, like a full-sized, like the biggest in the game, balers, tedders, and obviously a bigger bale hauler, or whether you would like to see seeding and fertilizing next. And one important thing to note is if you have something like this where I'll just show you, where one side goes up and then comes down, I would make sure you're watching it closely, especially if it's your baler, because what'll happen is you'll end up high centering the tractor on a huge pile of bales if you're not careful. But anyway, guys, tell me down in the comments what you want to see next between those two videos, between seeding and basically this video, but with big bales and hopefully everything working, since mods don't like me today. But anyway, guys, thank you for watching. My name is The Rad Man, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.